So I guess there's some news out there saying that George Floyd's second grade teacher shares essay he wrote 38 years ago. So this news came on June 4th, and I just now saw anything about it today. So here is a video clip of, this is supposedly the teacher of his second grade, Mrs. Sexton, and just the lady that was interviewing her. And again, this essay he wrote 38 years ago. And here's just a description here. Part of what his essay says is, when I grow up, I want to be a Supreme Court judge. George Floyd's second grade teacher kept a drawing and essay that he made 38 years ago describing his futuristic ideas. So yeah, 38 years ago. And what do we know about 38? RIP equals 38, death 38, murder 38. And, oh, I guess I put the murder 83. Murder is actually death, or murder is actually 38 and 83. And then he also died on 38th Street in Chicago, in Minnesota. So, I mean, what a headline to make about 38 years ago. Just more, the same numbers throughout everything with his story and more to come. So Sandra Bullock, her, the movie that she starred in, Murder by Numbers, don't forget, only the E's changed to 3 and the B's changed to an 8, like 83 and 38, like murder. And the teacher's name, Waynell Sexton, who taught at Frederick Douglass Elementary for 24 years. And she called George Floyd by, she called him Perry by his middle name. And she says, one of my favorite memories of Perry involves his report from Black History Month. And so, I mean, check out this essay. So supposedly this is the essay, and this is a drawing he did of him at a judge with his gavel. So it says, Perry Floyd, Future Famous Americans is the topic that she put out. I listened to the interview that she gave. So she gave a topic of what you want to be when you are a future American. And so he says, when I grow up, I want to be a Supreme Court judge. When people say, Your Honor, you did rob the bank, I will say, be seated. And if he doesn't, I will tell the guard to take him out. Then I will beat my hammer on the desk. Then everybody will be quiet. And then the sentence cuts off there. But I mean, as a second grader, do you really even know what a Supreme Court judge is yet? I honestly don't know if I even did. I doubt it. I doubt I even knew what that was until later elementary. And so what's interesting about this and her saying that this was from 38 years ago, well, Perry equals 82. And if you take 2020, subtract 38, it's 1982. Kind of interesting. And then also second grade teacher equals 155 and be seated equals 155. And again, like how they were saying that he died of coronavirus, 155. Second grade teacher also had that 83. Again, like how she brought this up from 38 years ago, the reflection of 83. And talking about Frederick Douglass and that being the elementary school that he attended, that kind of woke me up a little bit here. So this is Frederick Douglass, and he doesn't have his birth date listed, but his death date is listed, and it's February 20th. And I recently did a video that I'll show in a bit. I covered a Trump rally that was held on February 20th and what I kind of thought was foreshadowing the death of Floyd. So, but then before that, just remember too, Frederick Douglass was on the decoder back in 2017. And so 2017, that was on April 3rd, 2017. That's when this coin was minted. And what's interesting too is from February 20th of that year, the date, the anniversary date of when Frederick Douglass passed away, if you were to run that to the day that this coin was put out, it was 42 days later. So after his death date to the day that he gets put on this coin, that iconic 42 number that we see all over Black history. But going back, I do want to mention the reason I had even tied February 20th to the George Floyd killing was because May 25th was the day that leaves 220 days left in the year, and that just made me think of this Donald Trump rally that was held in Colorado Springs, which equals 220, and how in that video he mocks Mike Bloomberg and Amy Klobuchar. And in the video, if you watch, I left a link, maybe I can leave it again in this one, but I left the link to where he quotes, he's making fun of the both of those two, and then he says, "I can't breathe, I can't breathe," and he's just like mocking them and like acting like he's choking. So I mean, it was just kind of a weird day for him to do that on that February 20th, and then here we had Floyd died on the day, leaving 220 days, and I mean, that "I can't breathe" is so, it's just like a motto now, you know? So, I mean, a lot to think about there. I'll have to add it all together. But moving back to this is another reason that stands out too with Frederick Douglass is Frederick equals 164, second grade essay equals 164. And then, so this is the year that, again, Frederick Douglass was put on the quarter, April 3rd, 2017. So the day he was put onto the quarter to the day that George Floyd died was May 25th, 2020. It's exactly 164 weeks. So that's just something that caught my attention that I thought I'd throw in there. So yeah, from the day he was put on the quarter to the day Floyd died. And then George Perry Floyd has the 102, just like Frederick Douglass 102. And we're talking about second grade, second equals 102. And how, again, in this other clip I had of the whole connection with Bloomberg, Michael Rubens Bloomberg had that 102 to fit in even further with the anniversary death of Frederick Douglass, February 20th. That's just too much. And then also taking February 20th, so the death date of Frederick Douglass, if you were to run that from 2020 this year to the date of this news about the essay that was written in second grade, June 4th, it's 106 days later. So what about that, right? That's just that number we've been seeing all over the place with this George Floyd case and everything. I Can't Breathe 106, Black Power 106, Black Negroes 106, Rest in Power George Floyd, Justice for George Floyd, all 106, just to show you just the same news, different news, but the same numbers. But yeah, that was all I had on this one, but 38 years ago. See ya.